is a relatively new field called data science. It embraces a wide range of scientific methods, systems, and processes to extract knowledge and insights from data. Data science has to do with using past data to make future decisions. Now, there are many subcategories to data science, meaning it's made up of several subjects. One component of data science is statistical analysis. Statistics is the measuring of amounts or other numerical data over various lengths of time. For example, a set of statistical data for the real estate activity in a city might involve the average selling price each month for homes in this city, subdivided by neighborhood over the last year. Analysis refers to evaluating something, typically by breaking it into smaller pieces and reviewing each one. Statistical analysis is used to identify trends in different data sources. For example, it could be used to determine which online advertisements generate the most sales for a company. Here you can see an illustration of this. We would have two different campaigns for advertising, for marketing. There'd be campaign one with this description and campaign two with this description. And one could look at, over time, the resulting sales for each campaign, campaign one and campaign two. Again, very basic illustration, but this is statistical analysis. Data analysis is another part of data science and is broader than pure statistical analysis. Data analysis refers to evaluating data to discover useful information and assist in decision making. Any sort of data could be analyzed. One of the steps in data analysis is data cleaning. This is the process of ensuring the data is accurate by removing errors, getting rid of duplicate data, ensuring data points use the same measurement scale, for example, temperatures all being in either Fahrenheit or Celsius, etc. An example of data analysis would be attempting to determine which regions of a country have the most crime and comparing that figure to the police per capita to figure out how crime rate, number of police, and size of population are related. Here's a rough diagram of the parts of a data analysis situation as I just described. You would have data on crime, for example, a collection of data that included data about the infraction, whatever crime was committed, and the location of the actual incident. You'd also might have a separate collection of data about police, the size of the police force, size of civilian population, etc. And you might have a set of region data. This is just simply like, what are the different regions in an area? In our example, in a country. Could be done by latitude and longitude, it could be done by zip code. But the point is, if you have these three elements, you can have data on crime correlated to regions, data on police correlated to regions, and integrate those into one set of integrated data. Now in one place, you have data where you're relating crime data and police data organized by geographical area, and at that point you can start to do some actual real data analysis for what are the different relationships between size of police force, civilian population, types of infractions, where they occur, etc. There's a simple scenario for data analysis. Another part of data science is data visualization. This literally means to present data visually. It is presenting data in image form. Common examples of data visualization are pie charts or graphs. There are even attempts at 3D data visualization through VR, virtual reality, headsets or glasses that make the user feel as though they are in a fully or partially computer-generated environment. Let's say you wanted to visualize the various ages of people that watched a certain movie in the form of bars. Data visualization could be presenting that in bar form. I'll show you what that looks like. You can see behind me a visualization of the data related to viewership of a specific movie divided by age groups. You can see that if we had a total viewership of 100 and we graphed viewers vertically on the left here and we graphed age groups on the right, ages 0 to 12 would have 3 viewers of the movie, ages 13 to 17, 22, and so on. You can see here there's a total of 100 people that actually saw the movie, and you can get an instant idea of where your key demographic is for that movie. Again, just a simple example of data visualization. We've all seen these. As a technology professional, you'll very often make them for end users. The concept and use of data visualization has existed for a long time, but with recent technological advancements, the ability to extrapolate data has increased by leaps and bounds. A major topic contained within data science is artificial intelligence, called AI for short. AI refers to programming a machine to perform human-like actions, such as facial recognition or voice recognition. It's important to remember that computers are inanimate. They are lifeless. They have no mind or soul. They are simply machines that use plastic, metal, and electricity to process data. A robot is a machine that often resembles a human and can perform some similar movements to a human. And the term can also be used to refer to a machine that automates various functions. And artificial intelligence is a machine that is built to think like humans think. It refers to a machine that has been programmed to learn and to change its behavior based on its experiences. One of the purposes of AI is for computers to perform actions typically handled by people. A robot that handled all housekeeping and cooking, and that could learn from its mistakes, as well as come up with creative new food ideas, could be considered an AI, or an artificial intelligence. AI can refer to robots that look like humans, but at its root, AI is software that is programmed to observe and learn. An example of AI is voice recognition software, computer programs that attempt to process words that humans say. When you use voice to text on your phone, having text messages written out for you based on the words you say, this is AI. Machine learning, another branch of data science, is sometimes used interchangeably with AI, but there's a slight difference between the two terms. Machine learning is using AI to allow computers to learn based on data. It is a subcategory of AI that specifically relates to computers using data to make predictions or decisions without being specifically programmed to make those exact predictions or decisions. An example of machine learning would be image recognition. You could program a computer to recognize which pictures contain cats. You wouldn't have to program every cat picture that ever existed into the computer, but instead give exact parameters, instructions, boundaries that define the scope of a particular activity that lay out what the computer is to look for when scanning images. Then a computer could determine whether an image it had never seen before contains a cat. No matter how realistic AIs become, they are soulless machines. Humans and machines are not the same, they are very different. Any human connection one feels towards an AI is factually between them and the designers and the programmers behind the AI. The true source of whatever affection one feels for the machine is its human creators. Data science is used in conjunction with software development because much of the data science tools are software. For example, there is data analytics software, and you will have to write code to bring about machine learning. Those who work in the field of data science are referred to as data scientists. Data scientists must be able to perform fairly advanced mathematics. Data science is a highly technical field. Therefore, we recommend knowing coding prior to diving into it because A, for most people, coding is easier and so is a good first step. And B, coding skills come in handy as a data scientist because, as we mentioned, the two fields do overlap.